those hymns that we used to sing. And it just started to bubble in my spirit as we started to, before we started this. And so I want to welcome everyone as they join. You know, this song says, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Let the earth hear his voice. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Let the people rejoice. Oh, come to the Father through Jesus the Son, and give him the glory. Great things he has done. It's an old hymn. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Let the earth hear his voice. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. As you join, let the people rejoice. Oh, come to the Father through Jesus the Son, and give him the glory. Great things he has done. Morning, everyone. That was just a song that came to our spirit. My wife and I were just singing it just before we started. How we can wake up and praise the Lord and bless the Lord for all the good things that he has done. You cannot come before God's presence without praise and thanksgiving. God is a good God. Let me welcome you. We start with praise. It says, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Let the earth hear his voice. And I just want us to always recognize that we come before his presence with thanksgiving. We come before his presence with praise. We come before his presence because he is God and his mercies endure forever. Just looking for a psalm as I'm singing to you. You always have to come before his presence with thanksgiving. You always have to. That's how to come before his presence. There's a spirit. There's a the scripture is bubbling in my spirit. I'm just look. I found it. Psalm 100, Message Bible. Listen to this. It blew me away. Psalm 100, Message Bible. Welcome, everyone. I know I normally will call your names and all that kind of stuff, but welcome, everyone. But this song, it just came out in my spirit. Psalm 100, the Message Bible. And this is the real one, verse 4, the Message Bible. Listen to what it says. He says, enter with the password. Thank you. That's it. Make yourself at home. Talk him praise. Thank him. Worship him. The one I love is enter the password. Enter the password. The King James Version says enter into his gates with thanksgiving. But the Message Bible says enter the password. Thank you. So before you want to go before God, you need to put the password in. You can't get into your phone this morning without a passcode. You can't get into your laptop this morning without a password. He says the password to enter into God's presence is the word thank you. Come on, somebody. I just want someone to start to just say thank you. As you join, thank you. Melissa and Dennis and Nicholas and Lola and Tina and all those who are on YouTube and those who are on Instagram, I want you to say thank you. I want you to type the words thank you. You can even do that on your Instagram right now, and on those who are joined, just type thank you. He says enter the password. I'm going to read that again. The Message Bible of Psalm 100 verse 4. He says enter the password, and it says what? Thank you. He put it in quote. That's the password. He says enter the password. Thank you. And that's why we say thank you. And I just get some people who can just type in thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I just want us to blow this social media up by just saying thank you, Lord. I mean, you. I want you to say. I know some of you say I'm saying it through my voice. Yes, I know. But just take some time out to just switch on that light and just type Thank you. Thank you. Come on, those who are on YouTube. I want to see those thank yous going on. That's the password. Before we start praying, the password to going to God is called thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Psalm 100 verse 4, the Message Bible. Thank you. Psalm 100 verse 4. It says, enter the password. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Lord, for your mercies endure it forever. Thank you, Lord, because there is no other God like you. Thank you, Lord, because you have been faithful. Thank you, Lord, because you surround me with loving kindness and tender mercies. Thank you, Lord, because you lifted my head above the waters that I do not suffocate, under the waters and under the rivers of life. Thank you, Lord, because God, you went before me and made the crooked path straight. Thank you, Lord, because when I thought it was impossible, you, the God who turns the impossible to possible, you made a way for me. Thank you, Lord, because even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil. Thank you, Lord, because this virus did not take me. Many of us have had it, but it didn't take us out. Many people have had it, and they're now dealing with what's called long-term virus, coronavirus. But thank you, Lord, I'm still up. I'm still going. I'm still moving. Thank God for the devil wanted to devastate me, but God elevated me. Thank you, Lord, because the devil wanted to demote me, but God promoted me. Thank you, Lord, because the devil wanted to take me out, but God brought me in. Thank you, Lord. That's my password. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Enter the password this morning to your victory. Enter the password to your blessing. Enter the password to your greatness. Enter the password to God's presence. Enter the password that would allow you to access the King of Kings. Enter the password that Esther entered, that she asked the man, he's the eunuch, what does the king want? And the king gave her the password to get into the presence of the king. And the king stretched forth his scepter of affirmation towards her. If somebody wants an affirmation this morning, type the password and just say, thank you, Lord. Thank you. It doesn't matter how many times you do it, but it's just, you're just saying thank you. Thank you for all that you've done. Thank you for all that you will do. Thank you for your continuous mercy and grace over me. Enter Psalm 100 verse 4, the Message Bible. Don't ever forget that scripture. Psalm 100 verse 4. He says, enter the password. Thank you. Enter the password. Thank you. God is worthy to be praised. Sometimes we just need to clap our hands to say, God, I thank you. No, you deserve it. Not somebody's telling me to, but I'm just being reminded that you deserve the glory. You deserve the honor. You deserve the praise. No other God like our God, Jehovah. We thank you. We thank you. We give you glory. We thank you. Over worship tabernacle, God, I thank you. I really do thank you. We are in awe in what God is doing in Worship Tabernacle. We are in awe in what God is doing through the pandemic, when the news even in the Christian fraternity was that that's the end of churches. There's a new move. There's no one comes back to church. No one does that. God was faithful. We had more reach. We had more people that were blessing even online. What the devil meant for evil, God turned it around. God is allowing peace and joy to come to us. God, yes, we do ministry differently, but we do it with joy, a new zest of life. A new oil has come. The oil, the car was getting to a place where the engine was not functioning right. It was not firing right. We were overrunning the engine. We didn't take it back into the place of God where he could do an oil change, a filter change, where he could just clean out all the debris and put new oil in there. We didn't take our cars to the place where God could service it. We are concerned more about the work of God than the God of the work. But then came the coronavirus. It did do a lot of devastation. But the Bible says all things work together for good for those who love the Lord. I can see that God was able to revive us, refresh us, teach us new ways to live a stress-free ministry. And God has started to use things to us to make us more effective, more productive. And so we can still say thank you, Lord. But above all, he gave us a promise. He says, none will go missing. And to the glory of the Almighty God, the King of Kings, Yahweh, the Almighty God in Worship Tabernacle, none went missing. So we enter the password again and just say, Thank you. Thank you for your faithfulness. I love what someone put there. Thank you, Anna. Anna's just said, thank you, Lord, for all you have done. Thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you for your mercies. Yes, it is God's mercies that has kept us. It's not by our power, by our might. We didn't fast anymore. We didn't pray anymore. We didn't shout anymore. But God was merciful to us. Thank you, God, for keeping us sane. That's, I love that. Thank God for keeping us sane, for keeping us well, for keeping us in his tender mercies, for keeping us as the apple of his eyes. Come on, as I start to pray, as you start to thank God, look back and just say, God, I thank. It's not because you exercised well. It's not because you ate well. I mean, part of it was there, but we've known people who were exercising, who kept their stuff and still passed away. But it's God's mercy and tender loving care. You know, the basic thing is gushing. I was speaking to a gentleman yesterday, and he was telling me how God blessed him and kept him through some difficult times where everything was negative and it was supposed to go against him. But he was in Goshen. Goshen protected him. Goshen preserved him. Goshen kept him. It was a wonderful, mind-blowing testimony. I just opened my mouth throughout the testimony. I couldn't close my mouth. A fly could have gone into my mouth and come out and go back again. Because when God does so, he says, this is marvelous. This is the Lord's doing. It is marvelous in our eyes. I see the marvelous work of God in Goshen. And as we come into the year end, we're going to start to reactivate and say, God, we thank you for being in Goshen. To you be good, the glory, the honor, and the... I didn't prepare this, but God, we thank you. Just a password. We thank you. Thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you for changing the scenes upon our lives. Thank you for giving us health. Thank you for our children that we have not run them into the hospital. Thank you because there's no emergency over our children. Thank you, Lord. Oh, bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and forget not all his benefit. That's the password. Enter that password. God, you are good, and your mercies endure forever. This ties well with the prayer point. We're just going to take part one today, and then keep going as the Lord leads on my heart. I want us to pray about what I call the wells of joy, the wells of joy. That's what I want to pray this morning. So Isaiah chapter 60 and verse 15. This is the same thing that's gone with our thanksgiving. Isaiah chapter 60 and verse 15, the New Living Translation. Isaiah 60 verse 15, it says, though you were once despised and hated, with no one traveling through you, no one going through you, no one bothered you, no one cares about you. No, he says, you were despised and hated. He says, I will make you beautiful forever. Not for a season. I will make you beautiful forever. A joy to all generations. A joy to all generations. As I was in my study yesterday, God laid it upon my heart. He says, I want you to pray for joy over my people again. The joy. He says, let them dig those wells of joy. And one key sign of spiritual danger is losing your joy. You enter into the danger zone when you lose your joy. That's the reason why God, you said we should enter the password of thank you. Because there's a song that says, count your blessings. Name them one by one. Just don't, it says, and it will surprise you what the Lord has done. Because sometimes we just say thank you. But when we start naming them and counting them, even one can be more than 20 in somebody else's life. Just one blessing. Because one blessing, when you name it, you could know that that was the source of the other blessings that came. So one key sign of spiritual danger is when you lose your joy. And I've said this before, joyless Christianity is dangerous and makes one operate from a sorrowful spirit. This morning, sorrow does not only break the spirit, but it blocks your access to God. So we said, enter the password, thank you. Some people didn't do that because they were joyless. And then that, because you didn't enter the password, because you didn't have joy, you have no access to God. I've said this before, that until Anna started to thank God, what she was looking for didn't come to her. She, the Bible says that she said to the priest, "I'm a woman of a sorrowful spirit." And the priest, the Eli said to her, "Go, for God has answered your prayer." And it says she went and she was no more sorrowful, and God visited her. Progress is never made from a joyless spirit or a sorrowful spirit, guys. I want you to come back to those wells of joy. The devil knows that if he can keep you sorrowful, then he can keep you resourceful. He can keep you resourceful. I want you to this morning to start to pray. I want you to arise and strip off that garment of disappointment. I want you to put on the garment of strength this morning. I want you to strip all the linen, all the clothes of discouragement and despondency this morning. I want you to start to pray and start to declare that you're taking off that garment of disappointment and putting on the garment of praise. Joy needs to come back. Isaiah chapter 51 now and verse 3. "For the Lord will comfort Zion." Isaiah 51 verse 3. "In her capacity, in her captivity, the Lord will comfort Zion. He will comfort all her wounds." God will comfort you. "He will make her wilderness like Eden and her desert like the garden of the Lord." This is where I want you to underline. "Joy and gladness will be found in her. Thanksgiving and the voice of melody." Joy and gladness will be found in you. So start to declare this morning quickly that every unclean thing shall not prosper in my thinking. First thing we want to do is we want to strip that garment of disappointment. We want to shake off judgments and perceptions of others that is making you joyless. Listen to me, please. I want you to shake off that judgment. I want you to shake off that perceptions of others that are making you joyless. The things that cannot allow you to lift your voice and say thank you. The things that are allowing you to compare yourself to others and bringing you down. I want you to rise from the dust. Declare that I'm rising from the dust of my past. Declare that I shake off that judgment. I declare that the spirit of discouragement, the spirit of hopelessness. Come on, start to declare that the spirit of intimidation and heaviness. Declare that the spirit of self-defeat. Declare that the spirit of self-defeat, the spirit of toil and turmoil is deleted, is defeated, and is destroyed. Come on, I'm going to say that again. Start to declare that every spirit of discouragement, every spirit of loneliness, every spirit of hopelessness, every spirit of intimidation, come on, start to declare that, God, every spirit of heaviness upon me, upon my family, every spirit of self-defeat is deleted right now. Say, "I command it destroyed right now." Say, "I command it defeated right now in the name of Jesus." Come on, start to declare. I declare upon your life that every scar of ugliness that has detained your joy and happiness is buried this morning in the name of Jesus. So I want you to pray. Come on, I declare in the name of Jesus, the scars of ugliness, the scars of the past, I want you to start to declare that my soul awakens from the doldrums of ugliness. My soul awakens from the doldrums of depression. Come on, you can do it. You are released from the confinement. You are released from that numbness in the name of Jesus. There's some people here that are just numb. You're just numb. The broken pieces of your soul are healed this morning as you enter into the wells of joy. The broken pieces of your family are healed this morning. I declare that that wheelchair of paralysis of joy is broken. I command you to rise up and walk. I command that you'll be walking, you'll be leaping, you will be praising God. They said, "Silver and gold have I not, but what I have I give to you." In the name of Jesus of Nazareth, rise up and walk. Rise from that state of depression. You are released from that permanent state of tiredness. You are released from that permanent state of weariness. You are released from that place, that inability to function properly. I command you, release from it right now. I declare that your emotions are wrestled away from the oppressor into the sanctuary of greatness in the name of Jesus. Come on, is anyone praying along with me right now? You're glad you came on this morning. There is deliverance in Mount Zion. There's deliverance in Worship Tabernacle. God said to me, I wanted to go on another prayer point, but God says, no, tell my people to start to drink from the wells of salvation. Drink from the wells of joy. Isaiah chapter 12, please, before I finish. Isaiah chapter 12 and verse 2 to 3. Isaiah chapter 12, verse 2 to 3. I'm using the King James Version. Isaiah chapter 12, from 2 to 3. He says, behold, say this after me loudly, everyone. Say, behold. I want you to say this. I want to feel your spirit right now. I can't feel it yet. But I want you to say, behold, God. You got to say that again. Say, behold, God is my salvation. Come on, somebody. Say, behold, God is my salvation. Say, I will trust. That's what I was preaching on Sunday. Trust it. Trust the word. Know it, trust it, and do it. Know it, trust it, and do it. Trust God. So say this again after me. Say, behold, God is my salvation. I will trust and not be afraid. Say this after me. Say, for the Lord Jehovah is my strength and king. Say, for the Lord Jehovah is my strength and my song. He also is become my salvation. We're going to say that again. I want you to say that again. That's our prayer. Say, behold, God is my salvation. I will trust and not be afraid. Say, for the Lord Jehovah is my strength and my song. He also is become my salvation. Say this with shout this out. Say, therefore, because of this, with joy shall I draw water out of the wells, not one well, but the wells of salvation. Come on, start to pray. Joy. Therefore, with joy, you will not be able to draw water out of the wells of salvation except there is joy inside you. The password to salvation. Salvation in the Greek means soteria. Soteria means peace and joy. Soteria means deliverance. Soteria means well-being. Soteria means prosperity. That's why it is wells of salvation, not well of salvation, because the salvation has different connotations. That salvation has different wells. The land salvation has different wells. So you need to draw wells for prosperity, wells for healing, wells for peace, wells for joy, wells for greatness. He says, so, but I can only do that. I have the power. I can only have the power to get my peace, to get my prosperity, to get my increase if I take the bucket and the strength of joy. That's what I will lower it into those wells and bring it out. And that's why the devil, when he destroys your joy, he destroys your access, he destroys your function. So this morning, say this after me. Say, therefore, with joy shall I draw waters out of the wells of salvation. Say this. Say, barren lands will give birth to my expectation. Say this after me. Say, the mental barriers of the wilderness are broken today over my life. Declare this. Say, I declare new wells. I didn't hear you say, I declare new wells of fresh water will emerge in the wilderness in the name of Jesus. God said it in the previous scripture I wrote. He says, and he will make wilderness like Eden and deserts like the garden of the Lord. Joy and gladness will be found in them. So we're speaking and we're prophesying about wells. Say, I declare new wells over areas of shortage in my life. They're wells of salvation by joy. Say this after me. Say, I declare new wells of strange new wells. Say, new wells of strange greatness comes over my life in the name of Jesus. New wells will go over every area of shortage. New wells will destroy every incurable or strange sickness in the name of Jesus. Declare new wells over your finances. Declare new wells over your career that is under threat in the name of Jesus. Say, I declare new wells over my marriage
that may be on the brink of failure. Declare new wells over every purpose-based relationships in the name of Jesus. Declare new wells are tipped over your roof of dwelling in the name of Jesus. That anything that is waging war against your joy and expectation is broken this morning. Come on. Everything that is warring against the healing of God upon your life is defeated because you enter into the wells of joy and of salvation. Decree that I decree from the decree of heaven that my joy, come on, start to say this, will be full. My laughter shall not cease in the name of Jesus. Declare that in the land of this living, in my Goshen, that everything that is contesting my calling and my joy is destroyed this morning. Joy, 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 joy. Come on, joy, joy. I've got joy like a river. I've got joy like a river. Come on, someone. I've got joy like a river in my soul. Come on, someone. Declare that my time of laughter has come. Declare that I shall laugh. I shall rejoice in God, my salvation. Declare, say this after me. Say the season of sorrow will disappear now. Declare that my season of joy appears in the name of Jesus. Come on, you will no more be a negative expert in the name of Jesus. The joy, start to say, the joy of the Lord will build a fortress in me. The joy of the Lord will build strength in me. Come on, we've stripped the leaning of discouragement. We've stripped the leaning of defeat. We've stripped the leaning of emotional instability. Now we prophesy joy. Say, I'm made to fit. Say, I'm made to measure. Say, I'm made to last. Say, the load-bearing walls of my future are installed upon the pillars of joy. Joy comes back into your heart. Come on, joy. Joy is not happiness. Happiness depends on circumstances. Joy is a well that bubbles up. Joy is a force against darkness. Joy is what you need to break through the walls of containment. You are fit for purpose. By joy, you are fit for purpose. By joy, you're fit for purpose in the present and in the future. The Bible says you will be a joy of all generations. I want joy to come back into worship tabernacle. I want joy to come back into your home. I want joy to come back into your family. I want joy to start to build and increase you and multiply you. I want joy to reconcile the specifications of God's blueprint back into your life in the name of Jesus. Declare that I overcome every complexity this morning. I step into the wells of joy. I use that bucket to pull out my salvation in the name of Jesus. Come on, you start to walk in the training wheels of divine wisdom. Declare that by joy you set your feet on autopilot. You are following the ordered steps and straightened paths of the Holy Spirit. By joy you follow to your destination. By joy the Lord stitches your emotional wounds back to perfection. Joy would make that stitches come back, and it will clean you up. It will stitch you up to perfection. The joy of the Lord will plant your feet in the sanctuary of pleasures. Say, God, plant my feet back in the sanctuary of pleasures and happiness in the name of Jesus. I want you to declare that your home is no more barren of joy. Your home is impregnated by the power of God. I want you to pray this morning that the drought of joy in your life has come to an end. If you must cry this year, it must be the cry of joy. If you must cry this year, it must be the cry of increase. If you must cry this year, it must be the cry of salvation. Start to declare, let the joy of the Lord be my strength. And as I close, I want you to give you one more scripture, one more scripture. And it's the book of Isaiah. You could see we used Isaiah throughout today. Isaiah chapter 55, a common verse, and verse 12. Isaiah 55 and verse 12. He said this to the children of Israel. He's saying it to you this morning. It says, for you will go out from exile with joy. Say, I will go out with joy. Come on, somebody. I need somebody to say that. Say, I will go out with joy. He says, you will be led forth with peace. the mountains and the hills will break forth in shouts of joy before you. And the trees of the field will clap their hands. People are going to clap for you. Mountains will make ways for you. He says you are not going to be led out with depression. No, you're not leaving your home with depression. I mean, some of you say, I'm working at home. You're still going out. You're still going on to that computer. He says you will not go out with sorrow. No, he says you will go out with joy. Another verse says you will be led forth with joy. He says you will be led forth with peace. Two things will go with you this morning, joy and peace. And by that, mountains, as you go out to anything you're doing, mountains and hills will break also in joy before your children will break out with joy. Your job will break out with joy. Your finances will break out with joy. Your soul will break out with joy. Mountains, you know, even those things that are mountainous, those things that are difficult, he says it will break forth with joy. And the trees of the field will clap their hands. They will applaud you. They will applaud you. They will stand up and applaud the joy of God in you. The windows of unlimited joy will target your dwelling place this morning in the name of Jesus. Joy, listen to me, unspeakable, will erase the boundaries of limitations in your life in the name of Jesus. Your language will lack the vocabulary of soul, but your language will attain the vocabulary of joy. You will describe joy in your home in the name of Jesus. Say this after me. Say, I will go out with joy. I will be led forth with peace. Say, mountains and hills will break forth in joy before me. Say, the trees of the field will clap their hands. Say, I will go out with joy. I will be led forth with peace. Say, mountains and hills will break forth into shouts of joy. Shouts of joy. You will go out with unlimited joy this morning in the name of Jesus. The blessings of the Lord is upon you. The peace of the Lord is upon you. The joy of the Lord is upon you. The grace of the Lord is upon you in the name of Jesus. You will go out with joy. The peace and the joy of God will be your way reward. Father, we thank you for such a power-packed 30 minutes of prayer that is going to redefine lives right now in the name of Jesus. Redefine moods. Redefine atmosphere. We change the atmosphere of people's home back into joy. We change the atmosphere into peace. That every depression, every self-defeat, every sorrow, every discouragement that is roaming around their homes is deleted and defeated and destroyed. That we change the atmosphere of their home and their house into joy, a place of joy. That they will be leaping and praising God this morning. We bind the spirit of sorrow and we activate the spirit of joy upon our lives in Jesus' mighty name. Joy, unspeakable joy. It comes over your soul that everybody will start to see that you are a joyful person, not a sorrowful person. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen and amen. I hope you are blessed this morning. I hope the blessings of the Lord will rest upon you and the peace of the Lord will be with you. And I believe in the name of Jesus that God will bless you in all that you do. And the peace of God will be your strength. Remember that we have a Bible study this evening. And just a slight twist also. It's a question and answer, but we want you in person to come in church. If you can come into church. 7 o'clock, not 7:30. Let's just have some nice fellowship again. Just some questions. I want audience participation. We will be online too, so don't worry, we'll be online. But we just want you to just join me as you come to church this evening. Just and some of you just need to get out on a Wednesday and just find something else. It will make joy come into your life in the name of Jesus. And I believe that God will bless you in Jesus' name. And please, just to remind you, for the one-to-one socials for singles with games on the 7th of November, I want all ladies and men, guys, also you can join. Guys, just come out and just register. I know guys take their time, but I want to encourage you. We're just trying to create a safe place for you. You may think you're not ready,
But just even fellowship, just having friends out of your normal stuff will be able to help you and bless you in Jesus' name. God bless you and God keep you and cause his favor to shine upon you. And I leave you into the hands and the mercy of God. Go with joy in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah.